Alright, so another problem from the homework. With what minimum speed must you toss a 140-gram ball straight up to hit a 14-meter-high roof of a gymnasium? If you release the ball 1.3 meters above the ground, in my opinion, the problem says solve using energy. I don't really care what you use, but we're going to use energy. You can solve this problem from your other stuff in the beginning of the course. And part B, what speed does it hit the ground? Part A, you can use energy to solve this problem. Work, you know, change in energy or just conservation of energy? Which one are we going to use? Conservation of energy. What is the initial energy state of the ball? Do we have some kinetic and some potential? Do we have both? Do we have some initial kinetic energy? How do we know we have that? Because we throw the ball, right? If the ball has no initial kinetic energy, which means it's not moving, that means it doesn't go up, right? It had to have had some kinetic energy for it to actually go up. It had to have some initial velocity. We threw it. Does it have any initial potential energy? Look at the, what does the problem say? U, yep. Speak a little louder. 1.3 meters above the ground initially, yes. So this tells me it started out with some potential energy. It's already above the ground. So there's my picture, 1.3 meters. Then it goes up, hits the roof up there. What's its final energy state in the perfect world, in physics land? Does it have kinetic energy at the roof? No, we're assuming it just touches the roof, right? So it has zero velocity at the roof for that moment in time. So its kinetic final is actually zero. All we have left is potential final energy. Well, so this is going to be 1/2 mv initial squared plus mgh initial. That equals mgh final. We tell you how high the whole roof is. We have both h's. What do we see go away? For the 1 millionth time we've seen this happen. So that piece of information given to you in the problem is irrelevant. We don't need the mass of the ball. What about B? What speed does it hit the ground? What could we use there? We could go back to chapter 1, solve the problem, right? We know the height. We could use that. Or we could use energy again. Energy initial equals energy final. What's the initial energy state in part B? Where's the start of our problem in part B? I heard some mumbling, but I didn't see who was actually talking. Is that my initial state? That's my final state, right? So my final is just before, so there's at the roof, just before it hits the ground, right? That's my final. My initial is the ball at the top of the ceiling. That's my initial state for part B. How fast does it hit the ground? Started from the roof, falls down. So what's its energy state up here? We already decided in part B, what is it? It's all potential. So it's going to be mgh sub t for top, right? Total height. What's its energy state the moment before it hits the ground? Any potential energy? No, it's lost all its potential. It's converted it all into kinetic. 1/2 mv final squared. Again, m goes away. We can find its speed at the bottom. You already know the direction. The math is going to spit you out a positive number. You know it needs, if I ask you the velocity, you know that it's got to be a negative sign there, right? You can use your noggin now to plug in minus signs ultimately at the end. If I were to ask you to find the velocity at the bottom.